Hi, my name is Spiridon Crețu. I am senior engineering at LKB Bearing Industries. Today I'm going to present a seminar regarding the importance of roller profile in the performance of cylindrical roller bearings. The objective of this seminar are understand the role played by roller profile on basic dynamic rating load, recognize the dependency of the optimal roller profile on operating conditions, some case studies I am going to present, possibilities to evaluate the rating life of a roller bearing having rollers with modified profile. The content and two major modifications to the classical design have been developed to improve roller bearing lives within the same envelope dimensions. The first was incorporating longer and larger diameter rollers, but more important was the second, giving corrections to the roller raceway contact profiles. The magnitude of the elastic deformation of the roller raceway contact is some micrometers, so the profile correction have to be of comparable size. I'm going to present a comparison between four different roller profile and two different loading conditions, mainly stray profile, crown profile, ZB and logarithmic profile. Loading are small loads and medium loads. You can see on this slide the very important sharp increases of the pressure distribution of the end edges of the roller are present in straight profile, also in ZB profile under a wrong design. A comparison of the pressure distribution and also of the lives will be presented in this slide. It is pointed out that the straight design has a very, very strong increase of the pressure at the end of the contact. That increase is maintained in the crown profile if the loads are very high, and also in the ZB profile, but there are no increase at the end in the so-called logarithmic profile. But if we have a good design of ZB profile, we'll obtain quite a uniform distribution of the pressure. The analysis of the stress state has been realized with the three-dimensional stress equations, namely with the six components of the stress tensor presented here, and we'll obtain this slide, where is pointed out again the increase of the pressure of the end of the roller in case of the straight profile, and a very small increase of the pressure for crown profile, and no stress increase for logarithm profile. An evolution of the rating life, very poor rating life with the straight profile. Large rating life can be obtained with the ZB profile and especially with logarithmic profile. Cylindrical roller with straight profile. This design has a very abrupt discontinuity in a point A at the end of the roller. This disruption provides a very sharp increase in pressure distribution. And for this reason, this rolling contact is considered as being exceptionally stressed. The second profile presents the pressure distribution in 3D here, or in two dimensions here. The distortion of the pressure distribution generates distortion of the Hertzian contact area to so-called dog bone shape, this shape. I have to point out the very large increase of the pressure at the end. A detail of the previous 2D pressure distribution. The median pressure is about 1,000 megapascal, but at the end is near to 3,000 megapascal, three times more. The influence of the load. The load has a strong influence regarding the increase, the pressure at the end. here, along with the natural increase of the pressure in the median zone. The influence of the chamfer size, usually the chamfer is 1.2 in this design, with the increase of the pressure at the end, quite a uniform distribution along the generatrix, except the end zones. If we increase the size of the chamfer, we'll obtain an increase also in the median pressure. What is wrong? Maintaining also the increase at the end. Though it's not worse to increase this value. The circular profile is commonly known as crowning and has a constant curvature over the all contact lens. This one. There are two major disadvantages. The pressure along center line is far to be constant. Look here. And also a smaller portion of the roller is involved, particularly at light loads. The further design is so-called cylindrical crown profile, ZB. ZB profile contains a straight central portion with crowned edges. The existence of this straight cylindrical portion guarantees a contact length of at least 60 to 70% of the effective roller length, even under light loads. There are, however, two disruption points named A and B, which will be further stress concentration and concentration for pressure distributions. Numerical simulation of the pressure distribution in 3D is here. Two dimensions. The role played by the crowning radius will be present in the next diagrams. In this case, we used a radius of about 10,000 millimeters and the load of 25 kilonewtons. It's a good design because there is only a very small increase of the pressure at the end, very close to the median value. If we change the value of the radius R1 from 10,000 millimeters to 1,000 millimeters, we'll obtain something like that. A very small increase in the central zone, practically no modification of the pressure here, but a very sharp increase of the pressure at the end. If we will further will diminish the radius R1 from 1000 millimeters to 100 millimeters, the situation is worse. A greater value at the end. I mentioned before that the corrections has to be the same size like elastic deformation. In this case, the raise of about radius was about 100 millimeters is too large, the correction. The influence of the crown radius, a summary of the data. The good design against two bad designs, which have this very high pressure at the end. We're going to present the influence of the checkpoint. Usually we used a very small value for this very light load of 25 kilonewtons. The checkpoint value was 5 microns. And we obtain a very good distribution of the pressure. If we change the value of the ZK from 5 microns to 10 microns, we obtain a smaller length effective length, which will increase the median value and will maintain a very small value of the pressure at the end. It's not a good solution. For larger load, for 100 kilonewtons, the checkpoint value of 5 microns is not enough. Look here, we will obtain a very high values for the pressure at the end. Even the value of the ZK is moved higher to 10 microns, the pressure at the end is still high. We have to increase more to 20 microns. Also, they are maintaining the stress at the end, and even the ZK is moved to 30 microns, the effective length for cylindrical portion is diminished drastically, and the pressure distribution at the end is still maintained very high. We have to choose a combination between ZK of 30 microns and to diminish the radius R1. With a value of 5,000 millimeters and ZK about 30 microns, we obtain quite well pressure distribution. A better solution is R1B 4,000 millimeters. I think is a good design this position. Now, altogether, of the simulation data, influence of the crown radius, the influence of the crown radius, the increase of the pressure in point A and even in point B, when we have bad designs, like this one or like this one. The influence of the checkpoint value, the good design was presented before, is like this one, where the pressure in the median zone is very close to the Hertzian pressure, 2100, 2187. In point A and point B, we obtained very small increases, not very much. Possibilities to evaluate the rolling contact fatigue life of a ZB bearing. The usual method, laminar method presented in the standard, international standard ISO 281, and a new method, the half space method proposed by AKV using the Ioannidis and Harris theory. We implemented here the fatigue limit of the chosen equivalent stress. We will choose the equivalent stress proposed previously as being from distortion energy. We use a usual product law of probabilities to obtain finally the relation for the fatigue life of the bearing. In conclusion, to improve the rating life of cylindrical roller bearings, the primary target has been to reduce the stresses in the roller raceway contact by providing special profiles to the roller raceway contact surfaces. The magnitude of the elastic deformation of the roller raceway contact is of some micrometers, so that the profile corrections have to be of comparable size. The straight generative design generates an exceptionally stressed contact in the vicinity of the end chamfer that drastically reduces the bearing's life. It's a bad design. The crown profile design is not able to provide a uniform pressure distribution along the contact generatrix. Also, it's a bad design. The ZB design provides a central cylindrical portion that guarantees the contact length at least 60% to 70% of the effective roller length, even under light loads. The numerical simulation have pointed out that for specific load, conditions, there is a particular ZB design that provides the longest life. Thank you very much.